Hi, wrestling fans. Welcome to another action-packed, exciting hour of Smoky Mountain Wrestling. Professional wrestling the way it used to be and the way you like it. I'm Bob Caudle, along with Dr. Dirty Man, Dutch Mantel. Dutch.
I am here.
Yeah,
I am here.
Everybody knows you're here now, Dutch. You look like El Cid or somebody there today, by the way. Fans, I tell you, we got a great, great hour in store for all you fans. The Dirty White Boy is going to be in action. We're going to go back and take a look at some of the action last week, which involved the Dirty White Girl. I'm sure you remember that, Dutch. What a wild time that was. We got a U.S. Junior Heavyweight title match coming up during this hour. The Moondogs, they've been fined and they've been barred from television. And our main event, the Bruise Brothers against the Heavenly Bodies.
Oh, that's what a great, her? Great show here today on Smoky Mountain Wrestling. But today, for Tim Horner's second defense of the Beat the Champ, I'm going to draw a name, as I do every week. And the lucky participant this week for $1,000 will be Robbie Eagle facing Tim Horner today in the Beat the Champ contest.
All right, fans, as we say, it's going to be a great, great hour. Lots of action, lots of excitement. So stay right here with us and wait a minute. Bobby Blaze.
How you doing, Bob?
Fine, fine. What you got here?
I got a little surprise here. Chris Candido.
Oh, my heavens.
Look here, Chris Candido. You embarrassed me. You humiliated me. But you know what? I told you I was going to the board director of Smoky Mountain Wrestling. Thanksgiving Thunder Tour, Bob. This year, Chris Candido, I'm going to embarrass you like you embarrassed me. Guess what, pal? You're going to be the biggest turkey this Thanksgiving at the Thanksgiving Thunder Tour. Think about it, Candido.
Somebody's going to be tarred and feathered. There's no doubt about that one. Right? That's going to be the turkey match Thanksgiving Thunder, our turkey champion. Woo! Let's go to the ring, fans.
Ladies and gentlemen, this match is for the United States Junior Heavyweight title. Introducing first, at a weight of 206 pounds from Roanoke, Virginia, Jason West.
And here he comes, Bob, the WWA Heavyweight Champion and also the United States Junior Heavyweight Champion, the Suicide Blonde, Chris Candido. And you know, Bobby Blaze come out here just a few seconds ago and threw feathers all over our beautiful set. Now we've got to sit in a bunch of chicken feathers here for the rest of the program, showing us no respect, I might add. But when it comes Thanksgiving Thunder, Bobby Blaze may be covered head to toe and will be the biggest turkey in town.
That's our turkey title match, fan. The loser is the champion. He is the champion turkey, and he's going to be tarred and feathered.
Ladies and gentlemen, introducing the United States Junior Heavyweight Champion, weighing 230 pounds from Asbury Park, New Jersey, the Suicide Blonde, Chris Candido.
Hey, I hope you don't have an allergy with all these feathers flying around here, Doug.
Hey, man, I feel like I may be ready to sneeze here at any time.
All right, the Suicide Blonde, Chris Candido. I tell you, that's something I want to see. Somebody's going to be tarred and feathered at Thanksgiving Thunder.
Yes.
Somebody's going to get it.
You
Who's it going to be?
You
is it going to be Bobby Blaze or is it going to be Chris Candido?
It's going to be Bobby Blaze.
You're convinced.
I think Bobby Blaze would look good as a big turkey. Tarred and feathered on Thanksgiving now. And, you know, being tarred and feathered on Thanksgiving, that's worse than being tarred and feathered on 4th of July or Labor Day or any other national holiday. Being tarred and feathered on Thanksgiving is the ultimate insult, and I think Chris Candido is just the man to give Bobby Blaze his comeuppance.
Guys, let me remind you about InfoConnect, your voice information system. Carries the complete schedule of live Smoky Mountain Wrestling cards. Now you can call 615-581-1233, extension 2021, for all the dates and places. That's InfoConnect for all the information about live Smoky Mountain Wrestling cards. Give them a call, fans.
Good move by Candido there. Jason West went for an aerial move, a leapfrog, and Candido turned him into almost a mini power bomb. And Jason West, thanks to his little cute maneuver, now is getting whipped into the rope and back in.
I thought he was going to slingshot him off of the ropes and then come with a suplex, but he did not. Candido now looking around. Hey, you know, I can't wait for the big main event coming up. It's the Bruise Brothers, the Heavenly Bodies. What a time that's going to be. We've had some wild ones. Last week.
What'd you say about the Moondogs? They are what now?
They are not barred from television. Not only can they not get a license in Smoky Mountain Wrestling, but they're barred from television. Well, they've been fined also, Dutch.
Well, I don't see why They are barred from television.
See why.
I don't see why. I really don't.
Look at Candido.
Good move by the Suicide Blonde. Over the top to Grandmama's house we go, and almost got the three count on Jason West. Now that little referee right there, Mark Curtis, who I've said before is the son of legendary wrestling great Mark Curtis out of Jacksonville, Florida. He better not get in Candido's way too much, or Candido will turn him inside out.
One, two, only a count of two. And again, I think that time it looked like Candido gave him a little assist in getting West up off of the mat. Now he's going to back him to the corner.
Wait a minute.
Here's West up into the corner onto the top rope. And Candido now, he may be going to try to get up there, see if he can suplex him off of that rope, Dutch.
Yeah, he's trying for that suicide plex if he can get him up.
He's on the top rope.
If he can
connect
with
him. That's a long way down, man. All the way down.
A textbook
Jason
maneuver.
West. One, two, three.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of the match and still United States Junior Heavyweight Champion, the Suicide Blonde, Chris Candido.
Well, there you see Chris Candido with his suicide plex off the top rope and took him right down on it.
Here comes Chris Candido over.
I'm going to show you what Bobby Blaze. I'm going to show you what Bobby Blaze is going to look like at Thanksgiving Thunder.
He came over here. He's got the pillow of feathers.
The feathers.
He's going back to the ring with it, and I think this is to make a statement what it's going to feel like for Bobby Blaze.
He said he's going to show Bobby Blaze what he's going to look like. Oh, he's taking the feathers. He's just putting them all over Jason West, taking them out of that bag. Now here comes Bobby Blaze into the ring from behind. Blaze with the right hand. He's just throwing them all over. Look at the feathers. Fans, the feathers are flying, and we'll be back right after this.
Khaki's Lounge, the place to be in Hickory, featuring oldies and beach music with a splash of Top 40. If you want to wind down or wind back up, try Khaki's Lounge at the Ramada in Hickory. New Year's package is available in mid-December.
Fans, last week there was another chapter in the bitter feud between the Dirty White Boy and Primetime Brian Lee when the Dirty White Girl got involved.
Whoa.
Let's go back and watch some of that action that took place right here last week.
Wait a minute.
Here they are.
Oh, my God.
Here comes the champion, Primetime Brian Lee, accompanied to ringside by Tammy Fitch. Tammy Witch, the first lady of Smoky Mountain Wrestling, as she likes to call herself. But he has a swing, his arm in a swing. Now, Bob, is this supposed to be a title match?
It's supposed to be a title match, Dutch. That's right. Tracy, what do you make of this?
Wait a minute.
I don't know, man. I know one thing, them two, they ain't conceded. They're convinced.
Let's see what Tammy has to say here.
Lord.
Well, she has the microphone like she wants to say something.
What's he got, a swing on his arm there, Dutch?
We got to have an explanation here.
We need something.
Here it is.
Gosh darn our luck. Brian had a little accident the other day, and he hurt his wrist. He shattered his wrist into a million pieces.
Oh,
we have x-rays. He's in a sling. So, you know, I don't think he's going to be able to defend the title for at least another 6 to 8 months, so, White Boy, you're just going to have to wait until then.
If you don't think that I want to hit a cripple, you're wrong.
Oh, heavens. And the Dirty White Boy, it didn't matter to him, and he went right at Primetime Brian Lee. Something fell out of that sling.
It's a pair
of brass knucks.
Yeah, they don't call him Dirty White Boy for nothing, man. That guy, he'd knock out his grandmother to win a wrestling match, especially to win that Smoky Mountain heavyweight title.
Primetime Brian Lee, though, had brass knucks in there.
Wait a minute.
She sprayed something
in the eyes
of the
referee.
The referee got sprayed. Oh, and the White Boy now has got Tammy Fitch.
Oh.
He's going to spank her.
Well, heck, whoop her, man. You whoop me enough, whoop her. You got the chance.
There it is. There's one, two,
and here from behind is Primetime Brian Lee with a towel.
Yeah, he's a backfighter. He's a backfighter.
Wait a minute. White Boy's coming back on Primetime.
Now he's got the towel around Primetime Brian Lee's neck. They're going to try to choke each other to death.
Well, he's got the jet. Wait a minute.
Whoa.
There's Tammy Fitch. She has nailed the White Boy with that purse.
I know that feeling. She's done that to me 100 times.
And now that gives Primetime Brian Lee a chance to come back. He's putting those big number 14s right in White Boy's upper body and got him nailed down, pinned down close to the ropes.
He's wearing him out, didn't he?
Now, with a purse.
He's slugging with a purse, and Dirty White Boy hadn't got a friend in the world, Dutch. He's got nobody to help him.
Well, he has nobody to blame if he doesn't have any friends.
Well, hey. Let me tell you something. Like I said, I've said it 100 once, I've said it 100 times. He has dampened my spirits, and he's hurt my chances. That man, you could write a book on what he's done to me. I'm awful sorry.
Look at this. Just
I'm awful sorry,
him.
Fellas. I know he needs help, but doggone it, I just can't help him.
So
I don't care.
You're not going to help him.
No, Dutch.
Somebody needs to help him.
Hey.
He needs some help up there in the
Bob, with all due respect, they can kill each other for all I care.
Wait a minute. We got a visitor. That's the Dirty White Girl. Wait a minute.
She just dives in it. Tammy Finch takes her down.
Okay, fans. And Tracy Smothers has just left the broadcast booth. He is going back to the dressing room. Wait a minute. I think Brian Lee doesn't know how to handle this Dirty White Girl. He's like trying to get a cat off his face. Here's the White Boy back.
There goes Lee through the ropes.
Ladies and gentlemen, our next match on Smoky Mountain Wrestling is a one-fall match. Introducing first, already in the ring, weighing 250 pounds from parts unknown, John Hitchcock.
All right, John Hitchcock and Dutch, he's got a monumental chore ahead of him, as he's going to have to take on the man entering the ring area right now, and that's the Dirty White Boy, and I'm sure, haven't had a chance to look at him and to catch him yet, but I'll bet you money the Dirty White Girl's close behind.
Well, not only is she close behind, she's right in front of him. She's leading him. She's leading the charge of the Dirties to the ring, the Dirty White Girl and the Dirty White Boy, set to do battle right here. Smoky Mountain Wrestling. Let's hear the introductions right now.
Ladies and gentlemen, introducing the weigh of 252 pounds from Bexar, Tennessee, the Dirty White Boy, and he is accompanied to the ring by the Dirty White Girl.
All right, the Dirty White Girl. And she had a few remarks, I think, to make to the referee.
She'd like to slap his face, too. And I believe the Dirty White Girl, now I've been around her on several occasions. She's not a real big girl, but you know, a woman doesn't have to be big, Bob. If you've been around as many women as I have, them little bitty women cause you more trouble than anything else, especially when they're fighting over you.
Now you mean she's a wildcat, is she?
Now, I think right now, I would pay. I am a wrestler, and I am in the wrestling profession, yep. But I would buy a ticket to watch the Dirty White Girl and Tammy Fitch get it
on. I would myself.
Yes, sir, I would.
Myself.
Now
All
you
right,
see
the White Boy with Hitchcock into the corner. Not only is the Dirty White Girl standing by her man, Dutch, she's going to be at Thanksgiving Thunder other places as well to keep an eye on Tammy Fitch as the Dirty White Boy continues his effort toward that heavyweight title match. And Fitch is not pleased about that, to say the least.
Oh, she's a little bit perturbed, a little bit upset. Now, let me say one thing about the White Boy here. A lot of the wrestlers, now I've heard this scuttlebutt in the round, in and out of the locker rooms and all, they don't trust him.
Well, you know, he's gained some fan support.
Well, I don't care if he's gained a lot of fan support. What I'm saying is the other wrestlers here in Smoky Mountain Wrestling, still, they have their doubts about White Boy and whether this is a true transformation or whether it's just a fad or a phase he's going through, especially Tracy Smothers.
I was going to say one in particular, I'll bet you, and that's Tracy Smothers.
And I'm going to tell you what, I don't know if Tracy's right or wrong, but I'm going to tell you what, if I followed my own instincts, I would say he's right. Now, we're watching White Boy right now doing vintage, dirty White Boy stuff. Not a lot of finesse. Not a lot of technique, but a lot of brutal brawling and mauling on this John Hitchcock.
The DDT put him right down with it, and he is flat out on the mat. The White Boy, you know, he's mean. He's bad, bad to the bone, Dutch. There's no doubt about it.
Well,
and I think Brian Lee's been finding that out.
Well, Brian Lee has been finding it out and may find it out a little more in the future. Wait a minute. We got
what
some visitors.
Here's primetime Brian Lee, and he's got the Dirty White Girl, and there's Tammy Fitch.
Oh,
she clobbers her with something in that pocketbook. There goes the White Boy out.
They hammered the Dirty White Girl.
And fans, we'll be back.
And Smoky Mountain Wrestling is coming back to Paintsville, Kentucky at Johnson Central High School Fieldhouse Friday, December 3rd at 8 p.m. They're going to have a fan appreciation night. All seats only $5. Thanksgiving Thunder is on tour in Kentucky and Barberville at Knox Central High on Saturday, November 27th at 8 p.m. And Thanksgiving night, Thursday, November 25th at 7:30 p.m., it's Thanksgiving Thunder in Hazard at Memorial Gym. Now, keep in mind, it's WYMT night on Thanksgiving night. Kids under 12 get in for only 57 cents in general admission. In a non-sanctioned match, the Rock and Roll Express against the Moondogs, and a gang fight match, anything can happen, Jim Cornette's Heavenly Bodies against Ron and Don, the Bruise Brothers.
And let me explain something to you Bruise Brothers, just like I'm going to explain to all those rednecks up there in Eastern Kentucky. Like I've said before, there's labor and there's management. You got fired. You couldn't do the job. At least that's better than most of the people in Hazard. They've never had a job. 57 cents for kids because of YMT. Hey, everybody up there's got 16 kids. That's the only way they can increase their income. An extra check from the government. Well, let me tell you something, Bruise Brothers. You're going to be on government assistance after the gang fight match because the Heavenly Body's got some weapons in mind to bring. Everybody can bring their own weapon. Everybody can use it. Anything goes in the match. You got to knock your opponent out for a count of 10. You say you're street fighters? Well, you got the chance to prove it right there in Hazard Thanksgiving night. But we got a few tricks up our sleeve.
Thanksgiving night, Hazard, Kentucky Memorial Gym for the Smoky Mountain title. Primetime Brian Lee with Tammy Fitch defending against the Dirty White Boy with the Dirty White Girl.
Brian, I'm starting to get a little nervous. She's been making obscene phone calls to me, and I know it's her because she's breathing heavy and she's threatening me and saying all the kinds of things she wants to do to me. I'm starting to get a little nervous. You're not going to let her near me, are you?
No, you don't have to be nervous at all. All you have to be nervous about is catching a disease from Dirty White Girl. You know, Dirty White Boy, I can't believe on Thanksgiving we have to come and face you. But, you know, you better sit down at that table with your mama and your daddy and sit there and have a good Thanksgiving dinner, because when you show up on Hazard, it might be your last meal, and Tammy Fitch and Primetime Brian Lee are going to walk out champions.
Fans, the Four Faces of Fear challenge of Thanksgiving Thunder sees Kevin Sullivan out for the mask and for the hide of the bullet. After all the events of last year, this will be their first ever one-on-one meeting. So let's hear the comments from those two.
They say I'm getting out soon. They say I've been a model prisoner. You see, I'll be out for Thanksgiving Day Thunder, because when a fly landed on me, I wouldn't even hurt the fly. And they said, look at him. He wouldn't even hurt a fly. But a bullet is something else. A bullet is a man that's trying to hide his true identity. Bullet Bob Armstrong, peekaboo, I know it's you. And in Thanksgiving Day Thunder, you're gonna meet me, the man that you sent away. The man that you wouldn't pay his doctor bills. I didn't want to go on that rampage. I didn't want to do what I had to do. But in Thanksgiving Day Thunder and the Four Faces of Fear, it's all legal. I can dismember you, rip off your mask, reach down, and rip your entrails out. Such fun. Thanksgiving Day Thunder, and they won't put me away again. It's legal. What a great country. Thanksgiving Day Thunder, the Four Faces of Fear. Bullet Bob, I'll see you then. Thanksgiving Day Thunder. I'm all right. I'm all right. I'm all right. I'm all right.
Yes, I'm almost ready for Thanksgiving Thunder Part 2. I'm just about there. You see, I don't have a patch anymore. I'm seeing kind of hazy, but I am seeing. And if that referee will just lead me to the ring, Kevin Sullivan, alias the master, I'll take care of business. I've heard you so many times talk about putting people on the tree of woe. We're going to find out what that tree of woe is all about, because I'm going to strap you to it, and you're going to be screaming, whoa, 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 every time I hit you, boy. Get me off this tree and get that bullet off of me, because I'm going to be on you, boy. I'm going to be on you hard. I owe you now. You tried to take me out, it didn't work. Cornette tried to take the mask off, it didn't work. You're not going to get the mask. Thanksgiving Thunder's rolling, brother. It's almost here. It's going to be a thunderclap heard around the world. I heard the Japanese wrestlers are talking about it. The photographers are coming. They're going to see if the bullet loses his mask. Is it Bob Armstrong or is it not Bob Armstrong? Well, only I know that, brother. You're going to have to prove it. And you don't pack the gear, because you've got the devil in you, boy, and I intend to beat it out of you. Thanksgiving Thunder Part 2. The bullet's going to show you once and for all why he's bad to the bone.
All right, fans, with me right now here at ringside, of course, we got the dirty white boy and the dirty white girl, and she just is able to sit there, white boy.
I cannot believe that a man stands 6'8", weighs 300 pounds, wants to come out and jump on a woman. Where I come from, tough guy, we don't go for that kind of stuff. And white girl, I know you come to help me, but baby, I didn't honestly think that he was gonna do this. So from now on, you just stay at home. It's all right. I'll take care of this fight myself, okay?
Oh no. That witch made the biggest mistake when she put her hands on me. We come in a pair from now on. Where you go, I go. And I got news for her. I'm gonna kick her butt from one end of this country to the other. And baby, this time it's not a threat, it's a damn promise.
Now you heard it, Prop Time Bradley. Now you've lit the damn fire. You talking about wanting to get nasty? You want to jump my old lady? Well, by God, it ain't gonna happen, because wherever I go, I'm gonna carry this chain. And if you blink, I'm gonna bust you right upside the head with it. I don't care if the promotion suspends me. I don't care if they find me. I don't care what they do. Nobody on the face of God's green earth touches my old lady and lives to tell about it. And as far as that tramp's concerned, you get close and I'll choke your stinking turkey neck to death.
Fans, don't go away. We'll have more action when we come back right after this.
If you'd like to raise money for your school, club, or civic organization, and you'd like to see the excitement of Smoky Mountain Wrestling live in your hometown, this message is for you. High school and college athletic departments, sports teams, police and fire departments, JCs, civic groups, or any group wishing to raise money can bring the stars of Smoky Mountain Wrestling to town for a night of action and receive a portion of the receipt. Write to us or call Sandy Scott at 703-989-6819. Smoky Mountain Wrestling and your civic group, an unbeatable tag team.
All right, fans, here's Jim Cornette, the Moondog. Hey, these guys have been fined, and they've been barred from television. What the heck are
exactly
they doing?
That's exactly right. $5,000 they fined us for what went on here on TV last week. But you know what $5,000 is to me? That's a phone call home to my mother. And she sent a check down and paid for the little damage that the dogs did. Of course, how can you put a price on a human life? But you see, Smoky Mountain Wrestling once again is trying to discriminate, trying to protect the Rock and Roll Express, protect the people that they like. They don't want the Moondogs on TV. What are they going to do about it, Bob Caudle, huh?
What are they going to? I tell you what they're going to do. They're not going to let them wrestle on television.
Oh, and they said, as a matter of fact, they said that they would even send security.
Yeah, the Smoky Mountain security will prevent it.
That crack security force, Dutch, I know you know all about it. Well, let me tell you something right now. From the swamps of Louisiana to Smoky Mountain Wrestling, the Moondogs are here. They need some bones to chew on. They see some cats named Ricky Morton and Robert Gibson. And you know, everybody knows dogs don't like cats. So I'll tell you what we're going to do right now, Smoky Mountain Wrestling. We are going to, you know what? We're going to laugh in the face of authority. We are going to ignore the ban on the Moondogs on television. The Moondogs are now going to go to the ring and let the security come. Let the wrestlers come. I'd love to see somebody try to put the Moondogs out. To the ring, boys. Sick them.
All right. I tell you, he's just flaunting it right in the face of the Smoky Mountain authorities. You don't flaunt it like that, Jim.
We are flaunting our dislike of authority right now. I want to see somebody put the Moondogs out. Rock and Roll Express, they are the most dangerous team in wrestling.
We've got a television program going.
Well, it ain't going to go nowhere.
Oh,
who's this now? The crack security forces, huh? Who is that, Dutch?
That looks like like you said, the cracks. Those guys couldn't throw out my grandmother. Surely this has got to be a joke.
Who is that, Delta Force?
Is that the equivalent of the SWAT team?
Well, now, Dutch, look. You know, people are supposed to accept the authority of someone like the security force. They shouldn't attack the security people.
You're telling me, Bob, look at the security guy. He's already knocked out. He's down. And the other guy's down. Who else is in the ring?
They can open up the local bars. construction workers, the ditch diggers, the truck drivers, nobody.
What would they do without garbage cans and chairs and signs?
Why would they have to do without garbage cans and chairs and signs? They don't have to do without them because they are the Moondogs. They're wild, they're rough, and they're tough. And brother, they're coming after the Rock and Roll Express. They are coming after anybody that stands in my way. They're my big Sherman tanks and my new army that I'm putting together. And they're gonna roll over everybody, including the Rock and Roll Express. Smoky Mountain won't give them a license. We'll take the license. We'll make the license.
It's a repeat, fans, of what happened here last week as you see the Moondogs. As Jim Cornette again has just sicked them on, not only the security.
If the Rock and Roll Express had a gut in their body, then wait a minute.
There they are. Here is the Rock and Roll Express.
There's a Rock and Roll there in the ring.
Robert Gibson. Dutch.
They're trying to take the Moondogs out.
Rock and Roll right now, continuing to go at the Moondogs in the ring. And the Rock and Roll now, Dutch, they've got the equipment that the Moondogs came into the ring with.
Well, keep those cameras rolling there. The Rock and Roll trying to, the security couldn't get the Moondogs out, and Jimmy Cornette very, very upset that Smoky Mountain Wrestling won't give the Moondogs, two violent, brutal men from the swamps of Louisiana, Smoky Mountain won't give them a license, and now you see what's happening. If you see that sign, it says stop. Now, anybody with any sense will know, do not come in the ring with the Moondogs. And if you can't read it, they need what's given to them right there.
All right, fans, while we get order restored, here's a special personality profile on former UT Volunteer football great Mike Furniss.
Of all the outstanding athletes produced by the University of Tennessee, one name stands out as a superb all-around competitor, Mike Furniss. The brother of volunteer football legend Doug Furniss, Mike grew up in a family of athletes. At age six, he began competing in rodeos. A year later, at age seven, he began playing football. In his teens, Mike's sports career began to explode. He was voted Mid-America Cowboy of the Year at age 14. A three-sport letterman throughout high school, he was all-state running back and linebacker in football and all-state in track, shot put, and the 440-yard dash. Upon entering the University of Tennessee, Mike started every game for the Volunteers. He was timed by the Washington Redskins as the fastest guard in college football, running a 4.540 at a body weight of 255 pounds. Combining strength and power with his speed, Mike was a national collegiate powerlifting champion, squatting 755, benching 501, and deadlifting 705 in competition. After graduating from UT, Mike moved to Italy, where he played pro football in the Italian League, first as a running back for the Milan Rhinos, then as a player coach for the Torino Jaguars, leading his team to the 1991 Super Bowl championship. Now back in Knoxville, Mike is currently engaged in postgraduate work at UT and is active in community affairs. He has signed a developmental contract with Smoky Mountain Wrestling and is training at the SMW Wrestling Camp along with Tim Horner and other SMW stars. Mike looks forward to following brother Doug into the squared circle, where he will attempt to uphold the Furniss tradition of excellence in yet another professional sport.
You'd like to raise money for your school, club, or civic organization, and you'd like to see the excitement of Smoky Mountain Wrestling live in your hometown, this message is for you. High school and college athletic departments, sports teams, police and fire departments, JCs, civic groups, or any group wishing to raise money can bring the stars of Smoky Mountain Wrestling to town for a night of action and receive a portion of the receipt. Write to us or call Sandy Scott at 703-989-6819. Smoky Mountain Wrestling and your civic group, an unbeatable tag team.
All right, fans, out right here, White Lightning, Tim Horner, interrupted by Daryl Van Horn. He just came out and interrupted the interview.
Exactly. Tim Horner, I'm going to give you a chance right now in front of all these Smoky Mountain moo cows, these girls that worship you that stink of monostat and malt liquor, to back out of Thanksgiving Thunder right now. It's going to be the best move you can make, Tim Horner. You see, you better go home. I'm sure your mother's waiting for you in the tool shed. If you show up for Thanksgiving Thunder, Tim Horner, your career will end. All of those illegitimate children you have fathered up and down the road are going to be sad and sorry. They're not going to have a daddy anymore. I'm going to tell you something, Tim Horner. You are going to be the first person to find out that the history of Prince Karras's career will be written in blood, not wine. Wine is what we're going to use to celebrate his victories with. I'm giving you a chance right now. Go ahead and get out of it in front of all your fans, and I'll leave you alone.
Let me tell you something, Van Horn. I think you're full of crap. Maybe that's why your eyes are brown. I'm not afraid of nobody and never backed up from anybody, and I'm not going to start with you or your prince from Cairo. You got that? He better be ready, because I am, pal.
He doesn't talk to me like that.
All right, Tim Horner, he's ready. Let's go to the ring, fans.
Ladies and gentlemen, this match is for the Beat the Champ TV title. Introducing first, already in the ring, weighing 230 pounds from Raleigh, North Carolina, the challenger, Robbie Eagle. And the Beat the Champ TV title holder, weighing 230 pounds from Morristown, Tennessee, White Lightning, Tim Horner.
Well, Darryl Van Horn offered Tim Horner a chance to back out of Thanksgiving Thunder, and I guess he declined it. Am I correct, Bob?
Declined it. That's a mild way of putting it, Dutch.
Well, let's talk.
He not only declined it, but he went a little bit further than that. And Tim Horner's not going to back. He said he's never backed down from anybody. He's not going to start now. I tell you right now, he's defending his Beat the Champ title, trying to put another $1,000 in that pocket toward that $5,000 if he can.
Yeah, this is his second defense here. Now, you know, you can make quite a bit of money on this little Beat the Champ contest, and you never know who you're going to wrestle. So really, Tim Horner, he could be going in there against anybody. He could actually be going against Ricky Morton. He could be going in there against the Bruise Brothers, our primetime Brian Lee, Dirty White Boy, anybody. So really, just because you're the Beat the Champ doesn't necessarily mean you're going to stay that way for long.
Well, as you said, it's his second defense, Dutch, on his way to five straight in that $5,000 bonus. That's right.
I said that.
Now, by the way,
let's not be redundant, Bob.
Fans, if you'd like a personal appearance by one of the Smoky Mountain Wrestling stars at your business, call Pam Lawson at 615-587-1273. It'll really draw the crowds for you.
What's that number again, Bob?
Pam Lawson, 615-587-1273.
And you could even get me, maybe, to make an appearance at your car lot or whatever. See, Robbie Eagle right now, Robbie Eagle's the type of guy that sometimes gets overlooked.
Good belly-to-belly suplex right there from this Robbie Eagle. Eagle is an impressive youngster, Dutch.
Now, Darryl Van Horn, I don't know if the camera's on him right now, but
he is down there at ringside.
He is pulling a little scout work.
He's going to observe Horner firsthand. Well, get a look at him.
He's observing him right now, and he's seeing what Horner's there. There's a good shot of the man. And that man right there is always thinking, and you can't count this man out. Now, I've never seen him in action, but he talks a good game. And if he can operate half as good as he can talk, then I think he'd be a dangerous individual one worth watching.
I hope all he's going to do is just observe in there. And by the way, Prince Karras he talks about, you know, if he's one-tenth as outrageous an individual as Van Horn says he is, that's going to be something to watch.
Uh-oh. Robbie Eagle, he made a bad move there. Horner goes into his natural bridge. I've never seen a man kick out of it, and it holds true right now.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner and still Beat the Champ TV title holder, White Lightning, Tim Horner.
Boy, it doesn't take Horner long to pick up that $1,000, does it? He gets that money right away from that referee, Mark Curtis, and there you see Eagle made a very tactical maneuver there, and he paid for it with this defeat right here at the hands of Tim Horner, the natural bridge. Nobody's ever kicked out of it yet. 1, 2, 3 by referee Mark Curtis, and he wins $1,000. So let's go right now, fans. Let's hear more about Thanksgiving Thunder.
The second annual Thanksgiving Thunder Tour is coming Thanksgiving weekend to a city near you. Thanksgiving night, November 25th, Hazard, Kentucky at Memorial Gym, bell time 7:30 p.m. It's WYMT night in Hazard. Kids under 12 admitted for only 57 cents in general admission. Friday, November 26th, the Knoxville Civic Coliseum, bell time 8 p.m. Saturday, November 27th, Barberville, Kentucky at Knox Central High School, bell time 8 p.m. And Sunday, November 28th at Freedom Hall in Johnson City with an afternoon bell time of 3 p.m. Here's the complete star-studded lineup you'll see as part of Thanksgiving Thunder. The Dirty White Boy gets his chance for revenge when he battles primetime Brian Lee with Tammy Fitch for the Smoky Mountain title. The Bruise Brothers battle former friends Jim Cornette's Heavenly Bodies in a gang fight match. Anything goes, each man brings his favorite weapon, and falls don't count. You must knock your opponent out for a 10 count to win the gang fight match. In a match not sanctioned by Smoky Mountain Wrestling, the Rock and Roll Express face the Moondogs. The Bullet has accepted the challenge of the evil Kevin Sullivan for the Four Faces of Fear. In Barberville, falls count anywhere. In Hazard, it's a Prince of Darkness match. In Knoxville, it's a First Blood match. And in Johnson City, a Singapore Spike match. Will Sullivan get the Bullet's mask? Find out on the Thunder Tour. Chris Candido battles Bobby Blaze for the Turkey title. The loser is declared the Turkey champion and will be tarred and feathered in the ring. Daryl Van Horn unveils his Egyptian giant, Prince Karras, who will face White Lightning Tim Horner. Don't miss the second annual Thanksgiving Thunder Tour when it comes to your area. The Thunder rolls only from Smoky Mountain Wrestling. Now you can have the Bluegrass Brawl, Smoky Mountain Wrestling's wildest event ever on home video. Witness the three-team street fight, the Heavenly Bodies against the Stud Stable, against the Rock and Roll Express and Arn Anderson. Relive the magic of Tracy Smothers winning the Smoky Mountain Wrestling title. All matches complete and uncut. Send for a free merchandise brochure with tapes, shirts, caps, photos, and more. Write to Smoky Mountain Wrestling, P.O. Box 1279, Morristown, Tennessee, 37814. Order your merchandise today from Smoky Mountain Wrestling.
Fans, you don't want to miss Smoky Mountain Wrestling right here next week. Our next big main event is going to be a six-man tag team match. What a match is going to be. Jim Cornette's Heavenly Bodies, that is if they survive our next match. And Brian Lee, they're going to be teaming together to take on the Rock and Roll Express and Tracy Smothers right here next week on television. Okay, let's go to the ring.
Very good statement, Bob, if they survive today, absolutely. Because they got to get through today before they can make next week.
And I tell you, it's a mighty big order, Dutch. Here they come. Jim Cornette leads them in, the Heavenly Bodies. And Dutch, you made a good point when you was talking to me earlier that who brought the Bruise Brothers into Smoky Mountain Wrestling?
Ladies who's responsible? And gentlemen, here they are. They're the sexiest combination in sports. And the men who will conquer and bruise the Bruise Brothers. The Doctor of Desire.
Dutch for the Heavenly Bodies being in Smoky Mountain.
And here he is, ladies and gentlemen, seven times manager of the year, the man who is the brain behind our brawn, Mr. Jim Cornette.
I don't think they want me to get this out. Let's go over that again.
Okay, one more time.
Who's responsible for the Bruise Brothers being in Smoky Mountain Wrestling?
Well, it's got to be Jim Cornette. Is that the answer you're looking for? That's the trivia question answer you're looking for. Jim Cornette brought the Bruise Brothers in several months ago to take on the...
Get a real job.
Wait a minute. Here, that's a new song. Get your hair cut and get a real job. And here they come now. This is going to be a war, people. This is going to be chaos.
Into the ring, and here they come.
Here they come now. Here's
Candy Bar the door on this one, Dutch, as the Bruise Brothers admit that the Bodies are better wrestlers. But they say that no one can beat them in a fight. And look at the size of them, Dutch. Who's going to argue about that?
Well, they're sending in Jimmy Del Rey, the gigolo, for the ride. Meets a big elbow from one of the big Bruise Brothers, and they are pounding away. And these Bruise Brothers, they are big. They are huge. They're about 6'8".
And Del Rey.
I don't know what their weight is. What, 3'10", you think?
Oh, way up there, Dutch. And Del Rey went flying high into the air. Oh, and Tom Pritchard came right down on his face first. You know, I tell you, this is a preview, Dutch, of what's going to happen at Thanksgiving Thunder. These two teams are going to be meeting next weekend in a gang fight match. Each man brings his favorite weapon into the ring with him, and it's anything goes until someone is knocked out for a 10 count. How wild can that be when you got two teams like this?
Well, I'm going to say one thing. I'm going to have to question the sanity of Jim Cornette letting his team go up against the Bruises. Now, he may not have had a choice, but Jim Cornette on many occasions has dodged the bullet in many matches on teams he didn't want to meet until he was ready to meet them on his terms. I think the Bruise Brothers have gotten by that somehow, or they have made Cornette, angered Cornette so much he wants to see if his team can stand toe-to-toe with the Bruise Brothers. Now, I don't think that Jimmy Del Rey and Tom Pritchard can stand toe-to-toe with these men, because look at them.
only with a pistol or something in their hands, Dutch, I would say.
Now the reputation of these men, they are bar fighters, they are street fighters, and they have gone to it, the fighting, like I said, in the streets and in the bars. And they are not technical wrestlers. They don't know an arm drag from anything else, but they know a good right cross. And when you feel one of them from these big guys, brother, you've been tagged.
Well, you saw the Heavenly Bodies there for a moment with a double team, and now Pritchard, he's going to be back to the corner. Oh, that's trouble. That's no man's land. Watch out. He may lose his head right there.
Well, if the Heavenly Bodies don't watch out, they'll play right into the hands of the Bruise Brothers. The Heavenly Bodies, it didn't take a rocket scientist to see they can't stand toe-to-toe with them. Power or size-wise, they're going to have to
look
use a little bit of brain, see if they can beat these Bruise Brothers.
Look how high he is, and there's that shoulder breaker. Dutch, if they maul the Heavenly Bodies here and they really give them a pounding and a severe beating, don't you think that's going to have something on the mentally, the way they're going to get into the ring in the mental condition on Thanksgiving?
Would it have an effect on them? Yes, it would. I'll tell you what's going to have a big effect right now, that big 15 right in the back. That Bruise Brother is laying the leather to Tom Pritchard. And sometimes, you know, I wonder, Tom Pritchard, Jimmy Del Rey, Cornette gets them in these matches and they go out there and they get ripped from head to toe. Don't you think sometimes they might look back at Cornette and say, what kind of leader are you? What are you taking us to? You're taking us to a massacre. Unless he has convinced Jimmy Del Rey and Tom Pritchard that they're better than what they are. Now, I'm not saying they're bad wrestlers. They're excellent wrestlers.
Yeah.
But I'm saying, there's no wrestling in this match here. It's power.
Del Rey from behind on the top rope.
And good move by Jimmy Del Rey. That's the only way they can get the Bruises down.
Well,
they
got
to
a double team
them.
Going right now. Dutch and the referee outside of the ring. The
Wait a minute.
Bruise Brother was occupied.
The Bruise Brother
chasing Cornette around and around the ring. And his brother in the ring being pounded by a double team.
Now we see Jimmy Del Rey with the sort of the upper hand on one of the Bruises. Now, I can't tell them apart.
No, I can't either. Oh, Del Rey got high. You saw that kick.
Now, that's a good power move. They're going to have to see if he can nail that more than once. And a shot by Cornette. Now, we got a 3-on-2 situation here.
Well, now he's got to be double-teamed over near the ropes again, right in front of Cornette. Pritchard had a foot across the throat. Del Rey got several good kicks in at him. Now staggering to his feet over in the corner is the Bruise Brother. These guys are so big and so strong and so powerful. Dutch, they could take a tremendous amount of punishment and come back. You saw right there the Bruise Brother able to get a foot up into there. Oh, and Del Rey missed it.
Well, now,
he got a little fancy with it, Dutch.
Well, why would he even do a move like that? This guy's 6'8", 310 pounds. You know, those little cute little moves are not going to work on him.
Yeah.
He needs to just see if he can just get him down and keep him down and put the boots to him and wear him out while he's down.
You're not going to see any wrestling from the Bruise Brothers. You're going to have to fight them. You're going to have to maul them. You don't need to go that way. Pritchard goes down from a big 15, and that was right square in the face.
Right,
he's flat on his back.
Right square down. It looks like the Bruise Brothers are a little stunned right now from that shot and from Cornette and also from Jimmy Del Rey off the top. Now we got two fresh men in. Here comes the other big Bruise in. Now he's got a big shot to Jimmy Del Rey and another hammering boot from the Bruise Brother on Tom Pritchard.
Now, all four men in the ring now, Dutch.
All four men. Now we got a little activity. The playpen's not going to be able to hold them.
Outside. We got two of them outside.
Into the table.
Cornette with a big tennis racket.
Uh-oh.
Right, watch out.
Wait a minute. He's got Cornette.
He's going to hang him.
He's got him up.
And Cornette's going to go down with a big hands right around the throat from behind the Bruise Brother. Boy, I tell you.
And
if Pritchard had not been there to the rescue, there's no telling what would have happened with Cornette.
Well,
he's got a rope. He's going to tie him up, Dutch.
And trying to hawk tie one of the Bruise Brothers. Now, both Jimmy Del Rey and Tom Pritchard on the other one. It's a double team in the ring, and it looks like he's trying to tie him
to the ring post.
Well, that's a real good move on Cornette's part. Tie him up, secure him, and leave him, and then go work on the other one. They got the other Bruise Brother double-teamed in the ring. Jimmy Del Rey, Tom Pritchard laying the heat on him right now.
That's what Jim Cornette can do for you when there's a third man outside of the ring, and when he's as slick and as sly as Jim Cornette, he can do it. And right now, the Heavenly Bodies are really working over the other Bruise Brother in the ring. Cornette now still holding onto that rope, trying to keep the other one out of the ring. A knee drop now from Jimmy Del Rey. Here's Pritchard with a good kick in. They're just kicking, stomping, and mauling him right now, Dutch. And his brother can't help him. He's outside of the ring, and he's literally tied up out there.
Well, he is tied up. He's got another date and another appointment to make right now because he's all tied up and he can't make it because Cornette's tied him up to that through that ring post. Jimmy Del Rey and the doctor, Tom Pritchard, with the other Bruise brother down in the ring. Is he free yet?
Oh, he got free. Watch out.
Wait a minute, he's leaving the ring.
He got free, Dutch.
Is he leaving?
I don't know. He looks like he's going to leave.
Is he leaving his brother in the ring?
Did he just leave his brother up there?
Well, it looks like he's going out the side door.
Is he abandoning his brother?
He looks like
he's just going to leave.
No,
wait a minute. He's got a board.
Wait a minute. He's coming back into the ring. He went behind our broadcast set, and he's bringing in, look like a 1x6? A big piece of board. Oh! And he cracked it right over Jimmy Del Rey's head, and he has hit both of them. There's the bell. Referee Mark Curtis ringing the bell. Both men outside.
Hey, Dutch, in the gang fight, you know, they'll all four have something, and it's going to be legal, whatever they bring into the ring.
Well, let's see if we can get this. See if we can get any more action on this here. A little, maybe an instant replay of what happened. There we see one of the Bruise brothers rolling in the ring with that board. He's aiming it, and he connects on Jimmy Del Rey right down the middle. That's strike one, and he's out. And the same thing to the doctor, Tom Pritchard.
And fans, we'll be back right after this.
And Smoky Mountain Wrestling is coming back to Paintsville, Kentucky at Johnson Central High School Fieldhouse Friday, December 3rd at 8 p.m. with Fan Appreciation Night. All seats only $5. And Thanksgiving Thunder is on tour in Barberville, Kentucky at Knox Central High School Saturday, November 27th at 8 p.m. And Hazard, Kentucky Memorial Gym Thanksgiving Night Thursday, November 25th, 7:30 p.m. Now keep in mind, Thanksgiving Night, it's WYMT Night. Kids under 12 get in for only 57 cents in general admission. You're going to see a gang fight match, the Bruise Brothers against the Heavenly Bodies, and a match not sanctioned by Smoky Mountain Wrestling, the Rock and Roll Express against the Moondogs.
That's right, and who stands behind it all? It's Jimmy Cornette. But you see, Jimmy Cornette, how many teams did this make this that you tried to run the Rock and Roll Express off and you couldn't? But that's all right, because when our match is over, I'm going to sit back, and I'm going to watch the Bruise Brothers and the Heavenly Bodies have a gang fight. But you know, I was reading in the paper today. It said the Surgeon General said that smoking cigarettes and saccharin and the Bruise Brothers are hazardous for your health.
There you have it, fans. Thanksgiving Night, Hazard, Kentucky Memorial Gym. You're going to see a Smoky Mountain title match. Brian Lee with Tammy Fitch against the Dirty White Boy with the Dirty White Girl.
You know, Primetime, you and that little witch, all you've done is going around, y'all think you're real cute, going around making fun of Ron Wright, spending his money, and all you've managed to do is make a lot of people unhappy, and you happen to be looking at two of them. Well, the only thing I know to do is do what I do best. And that's beat people up. So prime time on Turkey Day, I'm going to stomp a hole in you and then walk it dry. And what you got to say about Miss Tammy, whatever her name is?
You know, you show up to Hazard, and you see this chain right here, honey, you interfere, and it ain't nothing for me to grab it and use it.
I guess you heard that. So prime time, just show up in Hazard. That's all I'm asking you to do. Eat you a big dinner if you want to, because I'm going to beat the stinking stuffings out of you.
Khaki's Lounge, the place to be in Hickory, featuring oldies and beach music with a splash of Top 40. If you want to wind down or wind back up, try Khaki's Lounge at the Ramada in Hickory. New Year's package is available in mid-December.
Primetime, Brian Lee right here, fans, and Tammy Fitch. Can't believe it. He came out and attacked a dirty white girl, this big guy.
You know, I wonder if that little dirty white girl has a little bit of a headache now, huh? Well,
yeah.
Look at the way she does. It's gotta hurt. But she's just like Tammy Wynette, standing by her man, just like a little housewife should. See, she's not like me. I'm a well-educated businesswoman. She is a housewife. She's good for washing dishes, doing laundry, and that's it. Well, actually, I kind of heard she's good for something else, too.
Well, you're exactly right, girl. She's good for something if you have $10, and the line's probably out back of the building right now. But I don't care about that. I can snatch a woman, or I can snatch you, white boy. Thanksgiving Thunder, I can't wait to get my hands on you, dirty white boy, and dirty white girl. I'll break you in half again if I have to. See you, Big Bob.
All right, fans. Tag team action, six-man tag team action, right here next week. And until then, so long for now.